Now, pretty busy this morning, tracking some local precipitation. Also, the latest on Florence, which is a massive storm out there in the Atlantic, making its way toward the Carolinas. So you're going to break it all down for us and any kind of local impact that storm might have on us. But this stuff right now, nothing to do with Florence, right?
No, this is our own little fronts coming through that are churning up our seas and actually bringing a change in our temperatures compared to what we've seen over the last couple of days. And some needed rainfall we picked up. Anywhere between half an inch and an inch of rain in most locations yesterday, a little bit less the further east that you traveled. And now on the radar, there's a few leftover showers, but the majority of the widespread rain is lifting out of southern New England and will turn into a scattered shower or a thunderstorm for the remainder of the day today. So not as rainy as yesterday and last night. Florence, Isaac, Helene, we have a lot of activity out in the Atlantic. Helene going to turn out to sea. Isaac, a tropical storm expected to track over the Lesser Antilles. And of course, Florence is the one to watch as it works its way towards the U.S. coastline. This is still a powerful hurricane, Category 4 storm, with the winds at 140 mile per hour sustained. And it's moving to the west northwest still at a pretty good clip, 15 miles per hour. That's cruising pretty good. But all of our computer models indicate that this will slow as it approaches the coastline, and that's not great news for the North, South Carolina coast and the coast of Virginia. It's a large storm, so as it comes in, this is 2 a.m. on Friday, getting close to landfall near New Bern, North Carolina, and then between Friday, middle of the night to Saturday, middle of the night, we're looking at it barely moving inland, still in central North Carolina at that point. So new this morning, National Hurricane Center has issued hurricane watches and storm surge watches from northern border of North Carolina and Virginia all the way down to southern Charleston in the Edisto Beach area. So it's slow strengthening, expected to continue. Could get as strong as a strong Category 4 or low-end Category 5 hurricane. Those new watches have been issued. Risk for landfall is late Thursday evening and night. The swells from that storm expected to reach southern New England by Thursday with some high surf likely. North Carolina coastline preparing for a direct hit. Narragansett, looking at our beach today, we do have a high surf advisory. Waves building the surf 4 to 6 feet during the day today. Small craft advisory in effect as well on the bay. Wave heights 2 to 4 feet. Looking at our temperatures, well, they are warming up in association with a warm front. That front is right along the coastline right now and will lift through. Cold front back to the west of us. You can see those scattered showers and thunderstorms. So we turn into the warm sector of this frontal system, and that's going to allow for a chance of a passing shower or a thunderstorm today. Notice, though, again, not widespread. The showers around this morning generally push to the north and east, and we'll get into a little bit of a lull. You'll just have to watch the skies in the afternoon and evening for one of those isolated storms could come through. As the humidity builds today, we'll be prone to some downpours. So a few showers for the drive into work early this morning. This afternoon, we're looking at a mixture of hazy sun and clouds and an isolated shower or thunderstorm. The temperature's up to around 81 degrees. And we do have a warmer stretch starting today, lasting all the way through the upcoming weekend. In fact, right now for us, the weekend looks very nice with that same area of high pressure that's going to provide dry skies for us at the end of the week. That's going to help stall out Hurricane Florence down along the Carolinas. So 78 degrees on Friday, Saturday's high near 78, 80 on Sunday. And on Monday, we finally could get some of the remnants in of Florence with some showers possible by the end of the day, Monday into Tuesday. We'll keep you updated on it.